Diagnostic medical sonographers operate special imaging equipment to create images or perform testing. In this video, we're going to help you answer the question, should you become a diagnostic medical sonographer in 2020? We're going to go over salaries, the job market, and the latest trends. Coming up. Hey everyone, Stephen Hack here with Career Watch, where we help you with your career search. If you end up enjoying the video, hit that thumbs up to support the channel. All the charts and graphs in this video are available at my blog at www.careerwatch.co. Link down in the description below. So diagnostic medical sonographers have a number of roles and responsibilities. These include taking a patient's history and preparing them for procedures. They prepare, maintain, and operate diagnostic imaging equipment. They review images and test results with physicians and patients, and they record findings and keep track of records. Financially, diagnostic medical sonographers do pretty well, given that they only really need an associate's degree to begin working. These salaries do not include overtime, bonuses, and other benefits. They are just base salaries from the Bureau of Labor Statistics. And luckily, they have over two decades worth of salary data. In 1999, the average diagnostic medical sonographer earned an average base salary of $43,760. By 2019, this average base salary rose to $75,780. So over about two decades, this is a wage growth of about $32,000, or about $1,600 per year. So over the past 20 years, diagnostic medical sonographers have seen $32,000 in wage growth, and this comes out to about $1,600 per year. So the estimated 2020 base salary for this occupation would be $77,381. Given that we have the average wage growth, we can actually predict wages 10 years into the future. So by 2029, the average diagnostic medical sonographer would have an average base salary of around $92,000 per year, if trends keep up. But one thing to keep in mind regarding wages is that geography very much matters for this occupation, for the wages in this occupation. The wages of diagnostic medical sonographers are vastly different by state. In fact, there is a $46,000 difference between the lowest paying state for this occupation and the highest paying state for this occupation. The lowest paying state is the state of Alabama, where the average base salary is around $56,000 per year, whereas the highest paying state for diagnostic medical sonographers is the state of Hawaii, where the average base salary is $102,000 per year. To view the top seven and the lowest seven paying states for this occupation, either click the description for this in this video or go to my blog. So what would a starting salary be for a diagnostic medical sonographer across the country? Well, a starting salary would be probably around the 10th percentile given pay. So this would put a starting salary of around $53,000 per year as a starting salary. And as someone in this occupation gains more experience or lives in a very hot job market, they eventually maybe get to the top 10% of pay for people in this occupation, which would be around $102,000 per year. Work environment also plays a role in the compensation of diagnostic medical sonographers. The highest paying work environment is outpatient care centers, who on average pay around $90,000 per year as a base salary. And the lowest paying work environment for this occupation is labs, which on average tend to pay around $70,000 per year. So how does this occupation compare to similar occupations? Diagnostic medical sonographers are out-earned by nuclear medicine techs, who on average make around $80,000, and they are out-earned by registered nurses, who make around $77,000 per year. But they do out-earn radiologic and MRI techs, and they do out-earn clinical lab techs. So that covers the compensation of diagnostic medical sonographers. The next question is, what does the job market look like? Is this a growing occupation or is this a shrinking occupation? Well, things are looking pretty good for diagnostic medical sonographers. Again, this data is from the Bureau of Labor Statistics, and they have around two decades worth of job numbers, employment numbers for this occupation. In 1999, there was 29,280 employed diagnostic medical sonographers. By 2019, this rose to 72,790 employed people in this occupation. So this is a growth of 43,510 jobs over two decades. This is huge. There's very few occupations that are growing this rapidly. In fact, the number of employed has almost tripled in just 2 decades. Another thing to look at is the number of job openings for this occupation, and then we can actually compare it with the number of employed. So I usually use Indeed.com. This is a really good job aggregator. And when I did a search for diagnostic medical sonographers, there was about 2,500 job openings. So basically I found a ratio of 1 job opening per 31 employed diagnostic medical sonographers. This means that there are okay job prospects, but there isn't like a shortage for this occupation, like there's a shortage for, say, oral surgeons or software developers. Now, certain occupations are very regional. This is not a regional occupation. There's hospitals pretty much in every state, but the states with the greatest number of people obviously tend to have the greatest number of jobs. So when we plot out the number of employed people in this occupation across the United States, as you can see, Texas, California have the greatest number of employed people in this occupation because they have the biggest populations. So what are people forecasting? Is this going to be a growing field? Well, the government definitely thinks so. They are expecting a 12% increase in the number of jobs over the next 10 years. This is kind of what that would look like. By 2029, they're expecting there to be 131,700 employed people in this occupation. So this is growing 3 times as fast as the average occupation. The average occupation is rising by about 4%. And again, this occupation is rising by about 12% over the next 10 years. So how do people get into this occupation? Typically you would need an associate's degree, or there are 1-year college programs that get people into this occupation. So the Bureau of Labor Statistics actually surveyed the education of diagnostic medical sonographers in 2017, and this is what they found. They found that 1% had less than a high school diploma, 7% had a high school diploma or equivalent, 17% had some college but no degree, but they probably had some kind of certificate, 43% an associate's degree, 28% a bachelor's degree, and 4% a master's degree. So almost 50% of people in this occupation have an associate's degree. So what kind of people actually become diagnostic medical sonographers? Well, if you haven't taken a RIASEC assessment, definitely do. There's plenty of free ones online. I linked a free one in the description below. This is a great assessment that kind of helps you figure out what your interests are. And after you do an assessment, it gives you numbers for 6 different codes, and you can compare your numbers with people in different occupations. So for people that work as diagnostic medical sonographers, they tend to score high in the investigative and the social themes. People that score high on the investigative theme tend to describe themselves as thoughtful, analytical, intellectual, complex, independent, and curious. And they're motivated by analyzing, inquiring, and researching. Whereas people that score high on the social theme tend to describe themselves as helpful, cooperative, kind, cheerful, and patient. And they are motivated by helping, empowering, and instructing others. So as you can see, there's pros and cons to becoming a diagnostic medical sonographer in 2020. The barrier to entry is pretty low. It really just requires either an associate's degree or a 1-year college certificate program. There's really good job prospects. Over the past 2 decades, the number of employed has almost tripled for this occupation. So there's probably going to be, if trends continue, great job growth for this occupation. Also, they're making pretty good money given that it only requires an associate's degree or a 1-year certificate program. There's very few occupations that just require an associate's degree that make more than $70,000 per year. And not just that, wages are growing pretty quickly at a rate of around $1,600 per year. Are you a diagnostic medical sonographer? Let us know in the comments below what you like and what you dislike about this occupation. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.